It is a call to know, love, and serve God, this divine presence among us. By dedicating our lives to serving the human family so as to create a more just society. Our founder, Father Stephen Pernet, an Assumptionist, understood this meaning of vocation, that all humanity is called by God to live with God, a covenant of love, to enter into God's plan. From the early foundation years of the Little Sisters in Paris, bonds were created and strengthened among the sisters, the families who were recipients of service, and others who not only financially supported the mission, but also rolled up their sleeves and worked side by side with the sisters in doing whatever was needed at the time. The real genius of this involvement was to build capacity and leadership among men and women who lived in poverty, and to build relationships between people from all classes of French society. These relationships in bringing together the least advantaged and privileged in a spirit of family allow people to discover that we are one family. Together, they share a passion to create a more just and loving world. When the planning for this celebration began, we were very clear that we wanted to honor the people who established our mission here in the United States, beginning with the Lady Servants in 1891, who were called through their faith commitment to offer their service in the homes of families and to work with the Little Sisters for the extension of the reign of God. It is because of them and those that followed in their footsteps that we are here today. Well aware that it would be a lifelong task to research the descendants of all those who assisted us in the early years, we decided to focus upon three individuals who represent a multitude of others who shared in this mission. Through these individuals, though they are situated in New York City, because of them, this mission has spread to Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Pennsylvania, North Carolina, Kentucky, and Canada. I am very pleased to say that with the help of a genealogist, we have located the descendants of three families, the Chaffins, the Kennedys, and the Wallaces, some of whom are with us here today, and we extend to you a most warm welcome. I would like to share a little about each of these families. April 1891, Mrs. Cornelia Chaffin, the wife of Lindley Hoffman Paul Chaffin, was one of several notable women recruited by Archbishop Corrigan to form a committee of lady servants who were to assist and finance the initial six Little Sisters of the Assumption from Paris. Mr. and Mrs. Chaffin were instrumental in creating the Committee of Lady Servants to support the initial United States mission to nurse and care for the afflicted poor of New York City. From the moment we arrived on the Lower East Side of New York, they had foreseen the needs of the sisters, made arrangements to have a place to live, and within 2 weeks, we were at work among the families in their own home. homes, barely speaking a word of English. Mrs. Cornelia Chapin is the first signature on the Articles of Incorporation of the Little Sisters of the Assumption in April 1891. From 1934 to 1951, Mrs. Martin Kennedy, the former Elizabeth McNally, was the wife of New York State Senator and United States Congressman Martin J. Kennedy. In 1934, she became interested in the work of the Little Sisters, thanks to her friend, Mrs. John McGrath. Together with other friends, a committee called Friends of the Little Sisters of the Assumption was formed. Their first fundraising event was a card party, bridge to be more specific. And it was held at the Hotel Commodore, and the feature of that evening and the next 21 affairs was a concert by the Glee Club of the Friendly Sons of St. Patrick. Elizabeth served as chairperson for 17 years, right up to 1951, when she was forced to resign due to failing health. Yet, despite her illness, she continued to help the Little Sisters up until her death in 1963. She was essential and instrumental to the work of the Little Sisters in her desire to see health services provided to those in most need. She kept the spirit of the Lady Servants of 1891 alive and passed the torch to more devoted and talented friends of the Little Sisters to come. And who was to come was, in 1957, Mrs. Stratford Wallace. And come they did. The friends of the Little Sisters benefited from her spark, creativity, and devotion. Under the chairmanship of Mrs. Doloria Wallace, the annual card party was transformed into a new and exciting event. It was now held at the Plaza Hotel, and its drawing card was the beautiful fashion show staged by Leon Brown, together with a list of magnificent prizes. Dolorita recruited lots of family and friends, her husband, his family, the William Wallaces, her family, and her children into the ranks of the friends of the Little Sisters, some of whom are with us today. Dolorita Wallace shouldered and chaired this event all the way forward to 1966. She supported the Little Sisters another generation, leading the Friends of the Little Sisters as president and making the continued work and mission of the Little Sisters a reality. Now, why mention these individuals? They are a reminder that the mission of the Little Sisters of the Assumption does not belong solely to the Little Sisters. It belongs to all of us. It belongs to everyone and has become a reality because of like-minded individuals who have responded to the inner tug of their heartstrings. That invitation to collaborate with others in the common vision, unite hearts in the spirit of family. It is a mutual gift which has been received and freely shared. Our congregation, the Little Sisters of the Assumption, consider all of you who are present with us today and all of those who were unable to be here, an expression of God's grace and blessing. We have come to know, through living each day, that grace comes in its own time and in its own way. Today, it has come as a bond that is created through the special relationships expressed in our sharing. To each of you, we say, thank you for giving us your gift, your personal presence, which marks the character of the Little Sisters of the Assumption. Again, I welcome you as family, as brothers and sisters, as I invite each one of you here today to relax, enjoy one another's company, and most of all, be happy.
child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled. The Gospel of the Lord. Speakers in the sanctuary, the friends and sisters of the Assumption. I asked Sister Jean when she called, why did you pick me? And she said, because you know the mission of the sisters and because you love the poor. But wow, what a wonderful invitation. And it reminded me of the invitation that I had from Bishop Vaughan many years ago to come to the parish of St. Patrick's where I met the sisters for the first time. But I said to the Bishop Vaughan, why are you considering me to St. Patrick's? He said, because you love the poor and because you're committed to prayer and spirituality. And I thought, that should be everybody's vocation, to love the poor. Very beautifully on your program. Lord, show me the poor, and I will run to them with a truly loving heart. A pace, coming in pace, that we heard also in the Gospel. Significantly, I thought that the Mass was going to be up in Walden, but that's where I know the sisters from, Walden, Newburgh area, the Newburgh ministry. And so I can't speak to the worldwide mission that you have, but so this church could counsel, not only Our Lady could counsel. I was with my twin brother baptized, he was 78 years ago. So I'm coming into the church where my parents and godparents brought me to be a child of the light, to follow the vocation of servanthood. And so it's a tremendous privilege for me to step through these doors today to just wonder about that, wonder about the connection. And that's really what it's all about, is the connections. My being here today, I have in front of me the faces of some of the sisters who are the faces of the Newburgh ministry. Sister Laura, Sister Sheila, Sister Monica, and the collaboration that they had with the Sisters of the Presentation, with the Sisters of St. Francis, and the Sisters of the Dominican Sisters of Cole, all of them collaborating together in the ministry with the poor people, the faces of Newburgh, who are also the listeners to God's word every single day. Beautiful ministry of Newburgh ministry is that they listen. It's a sacrament of presence. It's a belonging to the community in such a way that they enable it to be also the board of directors. I can think of May and many others who sit on the board, and I was in wonderment of that. But here you're not serving from a top, but you're listening to the voices from within. And that's so much a part of the vocation of the sisters, is that they have always had a sense of family and a sense of visitation. And they were originally going to be all the sisters of the visitation, except the founder was from the Assumptionists. And so the Gospel today, Mary running in haste to be of service to her cousin. If you've ever been to the Holy Land, it's a very steep and dangerous trip that she took at that Mary took. And she'd have to go up these winding hills to Ein Karim, where she'd be greeted by her cousin. There's a beautiful sculpture there of the pregnant Mary, not as pregnant as Elizabeth, but it's just a beautiful reflection on the meaning and the beautiful prayer that we hear today. The first reading is out and chosen also. I guess the Lord is trying to get through to me. This is the third time that I've shared this first reading in the last month. I was with the opening mass for these students at Maria Regina High School, 500 young women. And this was the Gospel that they picked, the first reading that they picked. Here is my servant, whom I have called. We are called to justice. We are called to be light bearers. A few weeks ago, the Sisters of the Presentation, 50, 60, 70 years of service, here is my servant, my call. sister and not just all in all of us. Why did she give such a beautiful history of the role of the laity? It's because you've been part of the mission right from the beginning, supporting and loving the sisters enough to do what they were called to do. What a privilege to stand here today to celebrate 125 years, but to know that it's only the beginning, that there's always more. When I came down on the train today to Mount Kisco, the person is placed on my heart, the symbolic reading of the word the sister did, but we had a man in Newburgh, his name is Gary, and Gary would push his shopping cart through the streets of Newburgh, collecting the bottles and cans. Every single day, he was known to everybody. And he found his way over to St. Patrick's one morning, and he came up for communion. And afterwards, I said, "Gary, I know you're a Catholic." He says, "Oh, do you have to be?" He said, "Well, ideally." "What does it take to become a Catholic?" I said, "Oh, you have to come and watch every day for a whole year," and then you, and not thinking that he would be that serious about it. He was. Every day for a whole year, Gary came. And eventually he said, "I'm ready." I said, "Oh, you have to pick a godfather." He said, "I already have to pick a god. He's going to be my godfather." So with the sisters, we've gotten used to, we welcomed into the church. And it might have been several months later, maybe more than a year, Gary was pushing the shopping cart one night through the streets, and he was hit by a car, and he died. And we received him into the church, his final mass. The church was packed. Gary was known to everybody in the borough. And I can recall especially the pastor of the Presbyterian Church, Carlos, Father Carlos. He brought in a little shopping cart that he had made and created out of little scraps of metal. And he held it up and he said, "This is Gary." So when we buried him, Calvary Cemetery, a parish cemetery, we had a stone made Gary, a friend to all, a stranger to none. And we had a shopping cart engraved on his stone with rays of light coming out from it, because we realized that he had carried the light of Christ to the whole community. And this is exactly what the sisters have taught us to do, to carry the light of Christ to our communities, to be of service, full of joy in what we do. And it's really a sacrament before us, a sacrament of presence. I can recall one summer we had students come down from one of the colleges, College of the Assumption of Massachusetts, and they were going to serve for a whole week, and then they gathered in Walden that night at the convent to share their reflections. And a lot of them were disappointed at first that they weren't building houses or painting fences. But at the end of the day, they said, "We were just invited to come and listen to the sacrament of presence." And I thought to myself, what a wonderful lesson for them to learn, that it's not all about building things as much as being present. That's the gift that I get, that I receive from the sisters as students. The gift of just don't do anything else. If the phone rings, put everything else down and present for the person at the other end. The person comes into the office, be present with our person, but don't be thinking ahead. So we have a wonderful example of just so much more ahead. Thank you for the invitation, for the beautiful witness on the altar here. We have so many friends and those that wanted to be with you today. And I'm sure many more could not make it, especially grateful for the priest that came down from Massachusetts. I think that you guys are all on the way. I was told that we were going to get you at the last minute, so happy to be with us. Let's continue the celebration. Let's continue to listen. Let us call each other to the service of the church.
La respuesta es, escucha nuestra oración.
In this year, proclaimed by Pope Francis a year of mercy, we pray for the Pope. May his example of humility and simplicity marked the church as we grapple with the inequalities and injustices in today's world. Lord, in your mercy. In thanksgiving for the blessings of the 125th anniversary of the Sisters of the Assumption in the United States, we remember with gratitude all of the sisters who have served here, those who have gone before us, and in a very special way, we remember that the sisters in long-term care could not be with us today. Lord, in your mercy. For the Navy servants of 1891 who provided a firm foundation for the mission, and for all the benefactors who have followed in their footsteps and continue to carry the mission into the future, Lord, in your mercy.
A medida que las tecnologías se expanden, haciendo el mundo más pequeño y el conocimiento de manera más accesible, usemos nuestros talentos y recursos para encontrar maneras de aliviar el sufrimiento de los migrantes, los refugiados, los desplazados, los que están atrapados en los esquemas de tráfico, los inmigrantes indocumentados y por todos los necesitados. Señor, en tu misericordia, escucha nuestra oración. Rogamos por y damos gracias a las familias que nos invitan a sus casas y sus espacios sagrados, en agradecimiento por el don mutuo de dar y recibir. Señor, en tu misericordia, escucha nuestra oración. En acción de gracias por nuestras familias y amigos que nutrieron nuestra fe, alentaron que la vida se comparte con los demás y nos apoyaron en nuestro viaje, Señor, en tu misericordia, escucha tu oración.
For all those who are sick and suffering, and in remembrance of our family members who have returned to God, especially Naomi Gilway, Lord, in your mercy. We pray for all the Sisters of the Assumption scattered throughout the world, France, Belgium, Ireland, England, Wales, Italy, Spain, Portugal, Tunisia, Burkina Faso, Democratic Republic of the Congo, Madagascar, Vietnam, New Zealand, Colombia, Peru, Brazil, Uruguay, Argentina, and Canada. And for our lay counterparts who form our family and mission, may they continue to show their love for others by sharing life with them. Lord, in your mercy. For the Canadian sisters who are part of the U.S. mission and later became their own province and are unable to be with us today, we give thanks. Lord, in your mercy. We remember the Irish territory who are also celebrating their 125th anniversary this year. In gratitude for the many sisters who have served in the United States, Lord, in your mercy.
Yes, but we could also remember all the men and women of the Winter Haven program, our homeless shelter in Newbury. If they continue to be sheltered and at peace, we pray to the Lord. O God, we raise our prayer to you. Shower us with your mercy. May it overflow into our relationships among one another and throughout the world. Guide us that we may come closer to realizing Father Pernet's prayer. Unite all minds in truth and all hearts in charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. revenue obligation due to the American Work of Human Acts will become more just and better life.
Thank you.
we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give you thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that you are taking of the body and blood of Christ, and may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring it to the fullest of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your presence, welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to inherit eternal life, and praise and glorify you through Christ our Lord.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you. Thank you. is in relationship. And from generation to generation, the Spirit of God has inspired individuals to share their unique gifts for the sake of this mission to which we have all been called. Today, we honor the legacy of the early pioneers in mission, the lady servants of 1891, who provided a firm foundation in the United States, the friends of the Little Sisters of the Assumption, established in 1934, and all who followed after them with tremendous generosity and dedication. Let us put our faith in action as we individually and collectively promise to journey together as one family in mission. So together, say, building on our experience of creating family, we are connected by desire to transform our world, beginning in our local communities. We commit to learning from and joining with the global movement for social justice. We are one with all creation. We partner with and celebrate the diversity of all those who journey with us. Amen.
To obtain your mercy for all through Christ.